Hello, welcome back. Last time I started exploring the Pale Village Zone. I haven't found the actual village yet. I fell down this pit and took on the Pale Burial. Yeah, it really looks like this continues past the stairway, but I'm not sure how I would get there. So my goal right now is to find the crafting altar, wherever it might be in this zone. Right, I've looked at that before. There's actually, like, somebody buried there, I think. I hear... Oh, right, the summon stone up there. Up by the obelisk. Right, so I didn't get very far. Okay, yeah, that's the way down there. Okay. I went down there, I did some stuff, I did a little bit on the surface. So let's just continue exploring this zone. I went ahead and picked up all the blueprints I have. I think this is all the blueprints. Plus all of the materials it would take to forge everything here. So once I actually find the crafting altar... Hey, what are these scrolls? Why am I carrying those around? Oh, hey. Why aren't you carrying that one? One more point in fire, and I believe you'll be able to learn that. In fact, I could have learned it now with that fire sword, but I didn't bring that with me. Okay. This is not going to happen. That one I can just leave in town. Okay, I'll put it outside the bag to remind myself. Okay, anyway. I see a tar bead. You are no longer holding the herb bag. Okay, right, so... Cold, icy water. Once again, I wonder if that has any different effects than regular warm water. Oh, hi, I'm gonna have to fight you here, huh? As I recall, these guys are a little nasty with the injuries. Although, since I have a paladin, that is much less of a big deal. Oh, hey. Ammunition for... I put away my rock thrower, didn't I? Well, that was inconvenient timing. Okay, well, I'll get it back again later. The stone heart. Trophy, part of the stone golem. Although just a piece of a stone, it possesses some magical energy inside. Neat. All right. Okay, that's right. These guys take, like, weirdly low amounts of damage. So weak attacks kind of just aren't even worth it on them. Like everything Ascalon's doing here, pretty much. Yeah, just ones. Whoa, 166. Wow, that's impressive. Okay. Right, you're carrying too much, because this ammunition's actually kind of heavy. 0.05 kilograms each times 10 is 5 kilograms. I can do math. Right, you're hurting a little bit. I can help that a little bit. Oh, I found my way to the obelisk. Neat. Whoa, that hurts a lot, actually. That's a problem. Okay, so you need to heal up before you fight that thing. Is your... Yeah, your evasion is lower than his, so that's why you're absorbing all the hits. I see. Okay, so you're pretty low on energy. Here, why don't you cast Mirror? And then, since you're dealing most of the damage... I wonder how Fireball would do against one of these. Can't actually see the damage numbers from here, but that seemed kind of effective. Yeah, you're hurting a lot, Mr. Ascalon. Why don't I just rest? Because I can. And right, I have this clock on me. Because I have a thing to do at a certain time of day back at the Rocky Coast once I get back there. I have a couple of quests there, actually. Valtharion can unpetrify now, so... Nice critical. So... I can do the encounter with... What's his name? The boss of the people. Whoever it was. So once I get back there, I'll be doing that. Go 13 squares west and turn north. Okay. Is this the symbol I used? I want to be consistent. Yes. Go 13 squares west and turn north. Okay. Cool. That's what this obelisk says. Let's see. Are there any... No, there's no interesting patches of ground around here. Yeah, right. I was wondering how you would get up to that. Now I know. Okay, pile of wood. Still don't know what wood might be good for, so I don't bother picking it up. Maybe nothing. I know you can throw it and do a tiny bit of damage, but that's silly. Okay, right, and I'm back here. All right. Hi, ice elemental. No, wait, that's not... That's just like a... That's an ice slime. Oh, that's interesting. I wonder how I would get to the other side of the river, if I even can. Oh, hey, a building! I think I found the village. Cool. I'm gonna save, because I haven't done that in a bit, and who knows how dangerous this village might be. I'm hoping not very. The Pale Village streets are empty, and if any people around, they are pale, hidden under heavy cloaks. Still, you have to admire all who, despite local condition, built this lovely village and made it livable. Go on? Okay. Alright, it's a place. Stables? Several horses are ready to transport customers quickly to Conwell City. Oh, yeah! This does have fast travel. You offered them your service to protect the caravan, which cover any travel expenses. Not right now. But I will take advantage of that later, definitely. Awesome. Right, I kept saying I was wishing for a hub of some sort. Ooh, that's awkward. right. So it's stables. Finally, I can travel quickly. So I wonder if I can just do that for free at providing my services of protection. I have a torch. You can have a torch. Sure. That makes it more pleasant in here. All right, you can have another. Why not? Improved mace blueprints. Cool. Oh, for the, a Valtharian mace. Okay, find the forging altar, two mithril, one Valtharian mace, and one improved mace blueprints. I assume you mean the paladin mace star, which I did not bring with me. Yeah, so this thing is probably about to be outclassed. It's barely better than what he was using before. Okay, so that's good to know. Shield potion. I never use those. I should do that sometime. Alright, well, cool. Still gotta find the forging altar. It's probably in one of these buildings here. Take that cart. Hopefully that doesn't mean I won't be able to travel now. Is this a... You have entered a spacious and homely furnished shop. There are a few people seated at tables around the room. Are there now? This place seems to double as both a shop and a local tavern. The innkeeper is an old dwarf with a stern look in his eyes. The dwarf looks at you and exclaims jovially, "By Rugar's beard, we have a new visitor! You have to admit, this dwarf is possibly the tallest dwarf you have ever seen. Come and sit, adventurers. We have warm food and a hot fire to warm your bones. Of course, I am sure you have something to pay with." He furrows his brow and with a keen eye studies both your attire as well as the size of the purse at your side. Quinn Molten Jewel. Okay. You settle in at a table and make yourself comfortable after a long trip. The dwarf introduces himself. "My name is Quinn Molten Jewel. The Molten Jewel part? Well, that's because there are stories. I was able to melt a jewel once. I am the local innkeeper and armorsmith as well. What is your business here, adventurers?" We're seeking a mage named Zashan. "Zashan? Sure, I know him. But let's eat some food first and drink some beer." Quinn serves you up another round of ale. Have I already had one? All the while chatting away incessantly. Okay, sure. You have to admit the food is delicious and Quinn is a great entertainer, as he keeps you laughing. As soon as that thought passes through your mind, the dwarf shouts out another one. "What did the dragon say when the man grabbed him by the tail? This is the end of me." Quinn, tell us something about Mage Zashan. "Zashan, sure. That weird fellow is living in his tower, north of the village. We do not see each other too often, as he usually only gets out to get some more food and wine. However, thinking about it, I have not seen him for an unusually long time. Maybe it is because of those nasty slimes surrounding his tower. Better if you check in on him yourself. Can you help us somehow?" "I am a brilliant armorsmith. If you deliver to me some rare ingredients and pay me some gold, I can make some wonderful items for you. Check the sign for materials and buy a recipe. If you want me to make you something, visit me in the back room where my forge is." "Thanks you, Quinn. We will be in touch." "See ya, pals." "By the way, how do you call a field full of dwarves?" A thicket. I don't get it. Okay. one of his jokes made sense. List of forgeable items. If you have the resources, buy the blueprints. Spider gloves, 3 spider silk. Ice armor, 8 ice shard. Dragon armor, 8 fire shard, 1 dragon shard, oh boy. Ogre amulet, 6 ogre tooth. Fire torque, 3 fire shard. Frostbite necklace, 3 ice shard, neat. Okay, good, I have some of those things. I didn't bring, for some reason I only brought the ones that I already had blueprints for. I should have predicted and brought more. Alright, I lit a fire. Okay, there's a fire lit in there. Oh, you can sell stuff. Cool. Alright. So yeah, this is another hub city sort of place, just like Conwell. Let me try this. It says that's a trophy. How much does it sell for? It doesn't sell at all. That's weird. So that implies to me that trophy's purpose is not just for selling, because if I can't sell that, unless different items can be sold in different places, I have no way to know. Alright, so let's make a better sword. 2 mithril, 1 rapier, and a blueprint. Ascalon's mithril rapier 1 has been created. Cool. Alright, so 14 to 42 plus strength. Alright, that sounds like an upgrade to me. Yeah. Very cool. And how does this compare? It's worse. Okay. So fist dagger is outclassed. Neat. Alright. That's very cool. Quinn improved your personal weapon. Now his name has 2 N's. Now it is faster and sharper, ready to slice and outright dismember your enemies. How are you gonna slice with a rapier? Can't that pretty much only stab? Right. Improved mace blueprints. Don't have the mace with me. Gonna have to go get it. You know, maybe I should try that horse stable system. Mithril gauntlets. Those are probably heavy armor. How close are you? You're close to a level up, and I think... yeah, next level you'll be able to use heavy armor. Sure, let's just make them. That sounds like fun. Mithril gauntlets been created. No, it's light armor. Protection, resist all, plus 2. Neat. Whoa, that is some incredible amount of protection for just some gloves. These go to Valtharion. He needs more. I would like to make more of those. I'm going to be buying mithril back at the jeweler in Conwell, I think. Unless, perhaps this guy sells some? Oh, you're a blueprints guy, of course. Serpent blade. Oh, I know that one. 1339 plus dex. So that's similar to... no, it's different. It's better. Well, that's a nice dagger. 1 gold, 2 silver. Bone blade, vampiric. Oh, yeah. I remember vampiric weapons. Heavy weapon, saber. Heavy two-handed maul. Hot napalm. That's where you can get this. I assume that's fire napalm. Okay. Fortune cookie, bread. 2 copper. Yeah, same price. Good. Yeah, 3 silver for mithril. I don't have to go back there to buy it. Spider gloves. Do I want spider gloves? I have spider silk back at... okay, so I should bring... I'm going to bring all of my crafting ingredients here and leave them in this room. This will be the home for those now. Let's see, what else am I going to do? Didn't I bring a third blueprint? Fire gauntlets. Oh, right. It consumes the blueprints. Did you sell mithril gloves blueprints? Dragon armor, ogre amulet, fire target necklace. No, you do not sell mithril gloves blueprints. Okay, so that's a one-time sort of thing. Got it. All right, well, let's make this. Gauntlets of fire. Protection plus 5, resist fire plus 15. Okay, great. Turns damage type of melee attacks to fire damage. That's... questionable. If I'm fighting any fire elementals, I don't want those on. But I'll keep them on me for now. Definitely appropriate for this zone. Okay. So Valtharion's mace, all the crafting ingredients are things I want to bring. Oh yeah, I remember that. Mage Zashan is up north, apparently, this direction. Right, I'm across the river, I saw those ice slimes over there, so this is my destination for that. Yeah, so now that I've found this, the game's pretty open. There's a lot of places that I could go. By the Garud's Bear, you are leaving? I wish you good luck, pals. How do we get into the tower? I used to have an invitation letter, but pals, I lost it. I am sure you are going to need something similar. Really? So he just doesn't, he's... I have to be invited in. I can't just come and knock on his door or something. Tell us some joke before we leave. And lady rocking on her front porch wistfully reflected on her long life. Abruptly, her fairy godmother suddenly appeared before her and said she'd grant her 3 wishes and sorry for the delay. What? Well, said the woman, if you really are my fairy godmother, make me rich beyond my wildest dreams. She was amazed as her house turned to solid gold with emerald decorated windows. Wow, can you turn me into a beautiful young princess? She said. Without a word, the fairy godmother waved her wand and the elderly lady was transformed into a beautiful young princess. Oh man, so she got youth out of that. That's valuable. Your 3rd wish? Asked the fairy godmother. Just then, the old woman's cat wandered across the porch in front of them. Oh, the woman said, please turn my cat into a handsome young prince. With a swish of her wand, the cat was transformed and standing before her was a handsome young man with long flowing hair. She looked up at him, love reflected in her young eyes. Smiling, he bent down and said, I'll bet now you're sorry you had me neutered. Ah, poor kitty, prince. Yeah. What's this? A rooftop, kinda. Why would I want to come up here? Who knows? Mm-hmm. Wait, there's another shrine here? Where's the entrance? Oh, do you wish to enter the Pale Church? Sure. Whoa. Okay. Does this... Is that a free crystal? I didn't see a... Whoa. Wait, what? What up with all this stuff? I don't feel entirely right with just taking these things. Can I... Is this... It's not guarded. Will anyone come after me if I do? Torchbearer shield. Oh, hey! This is a thing you need. Requires light magic 4. Heal party. Ooh, cool. Okay. So this gives protection instead of evasion. Doesn't give strength. Who cares? That's really good. Okay, sure. You can have this old one. yep. And then I can steal it. Oh, wait. That's not money. It looks the same as a gold coin. Alright. Where it gains experience. Oh, cool! Experience booster. Cold and shiny, this amulet is holding many memories, and experience will forever remind you of reaching the Pale Village. So, Mortimer is nowhere near as behind as he used to be, but he's still behind a little bit. Alright. Cool. Yeah, so this is a crystal of life that it looks like I can just use. Very nice. Alright. Man, so much stuff here. Okay. So leaving the village this way. Is this north? This is north. You're not... Uh-oh. Let's just go back into the village, wherever it was. There we go. I'm guessing those won't follow me in. Oh, cool. Oh, right, I ate at the inn, so everybody is filled. That's nice. Alright, what else is there here? More slimes. It's gonna take my fingers a while to learn that Mortimer carries herbs now. Okay. Why is this the Pale Village? What's pale about it? I never quite followed that. Huh. Okay. Looks like a gold keyhole to me. Oh, suspicious. Should I dig? Sure, why not? I like my sword! Found nothing. Alright, so I ruined that circle of stones. Possible summoning circle. I wonder why that's there. Get the rock thrower too while you're in the village, the city. I say to myself. Okay, so here's the stables. What building is this? Whoa. Whole room is scented by mysterious ingredients. Although shop is dark, cozy fireplace make it brighter than it is. Good day to you, adventurers. Gorgeous woman is preparing some potion while watching you from the alchemy pult. Pult? You have to admit she is the most beautiful alchemist you have ever seen. Can I help you somehow? Elune. Wait a minute. Elune, I've heard your name before. Hello, Elune. We have not seen each other for a quite long time. Is that Avi? Is that really you? She is with smile warmly welcoming your party member. Oh, Avi, look at you. When I last seen you, you were just a girl. They started some woman conversation, and after a while, Avi is introducing you and rest of the party. So, what are you doing in the Pale Village? I do not think you are here just to visit me, right? We have some things to do here. I understand. It is hard to believe somebody in these times. Tell me, can I help you somehow? We're looking for Mage Zashin. Zashin, yes, I know him. A lonely, handsome guy. He is buying some ingredients here quite often. I bet he do not require majority of them. I wonder why he is buying it. He is living in the Mage Tower north from the Pale Village. You cannot miss it. It is quite a long time I have seen him lately. Hope something wrong does not happen to him. Some interesting news around lately. Weather is bass as usually, but lots of monsters crawling around lately. I have even problems go to the marsh, pick up some ingredients. The Eastern Frozen Lake. Sorry, I was trying to hold it together. So reading this is kind of a highlight for me of playing this. I find the broken English endearing, honestly. But it is a challenge to read sometimes. The Eastern Frozen Lake is calm. All tough, it's like silence be over the storm, if you understand me. Whew. Can we help you somehow? Can you help? Whatever. I am in need of some ingredients. I can cast this while dialogue is going on. Here, take the list. Some of them are quite rare, but maybe you will find them on your travel. When you have them all, return back to me. I am sure I will find some fine reward for you. Okay, cool. My shop is open for you whenever you wish. You can also freely use my magical alchemy altar if you want. Oh yeah? Alchemy altar? You can prepare many interesting elixirs with the right ingredients. In case you are interested in the alchemy, of course, check my recipes. Seems that's all for now. Avi chats with Elune for a while, and you are ready to leave. Okay, cool. So that perhaps will explain what the tarbead and blood drop blossom and stuff are for. Golem heart, usually held by stone golems. I have three of them. Solid ice shard, rare and special shard, unknown location. Solid ice shard. I don't think I have one of those. A frozen ether weed could be found in the mountains. So, an ether weed that has to be frozen? Known recipes. Black moss, ether weed, falcon skyr, bloodcap bomb. Oh. Does this mean that I don't need to know alchemy myself? I can have Elun do it for me? I wonder. Healing potion. Greater healing potion. Yeah, okay. Fascinating. Well, that's good to know. Death bomb. Death bomb? That's different. Resurrection potion. Alternate permanent strength. What? That sounds interesting. Alternate permanent strength. Okay, so that's probably for the... willpower, vitality... Not dexterity, though. Concentrated energy potion. That was the thing that I wasted with her, wasn't it? Skeleton bone. Potion and ingredient poison. Empty flask for preparing po- Oh. Really? I have one of those. Oh, I see. So this kind of alchemy needs empty flasks. Okay. Well, this is suddenly complicated. I don't think I wish to do any alchemy now, but perhaps... Nah. I was thinking I might leave some stuff there, but I don't feel like it. Okay, so alchemy shop there. Good to know. Right, I've been there. There's a gate. Right, I looked at that. What's this building here? Just a generic house. Okay. So I want to take a trip back to Conwell and pick up a bunch of ingredients and things. There's a chest there. There's a chest there. Have I opened both of those? I opened this one, I remember. Shrine... Transport. So yeah, what's up with the chest over here? Also... Oh, it's barrels, I see. I was slightly confused. Okay, Alright, so, stables. Do you wish to enter the Pale Church? No, not now. Several horses travel to the Conwell City. We are departing in a minute. Be prepared. Okay. Whoa. Okay. Alright. Well, that was cool. Didn't have to do any combat along the way to protect them or anything. Right, so I'm here for Rock Thrower, because I have a bunch of rocks again. Rock Thrower is still pretty cool. Even if it is outclassed by a lot of the stuff I have now. I do want to use up my rocks with it. Okay, so lots of ingredients and things. My mithril. Let's see, so that's a trophy. Could be sold. Ice Plate Shard. Doesn't say solid ice shard, that's different. Bones, that's a trophy. Trophy... Okay, so this becomes my trophy chest now. That's... Oh yeah, spider silk. I only have two. Okay, so I need one more for stuff. Ogre teeth... Fallen meteor. I'm starting to get the impression this is something a little more than an ingredient, and I didn't see any... recipes that used it. So I think I'll leave those here for now. What's this? Oh, empty flask. Well, that's useful. I'm glad I kept it around. Sure, I'll just stick that in there. Heavy shield of bashing, rock thrower. For you. Knife thrower, no, leaf bond. Paladin mace star, yes. Uh-huh. Steel armband, crossbow coral shuriken, spirit crook. Okay, here, why don't I give you this for a moment and have you read a scroll. Fireball! Very cool. Yeah, whatever. Actually, I can just discard this now. Here's fine. Where did I put... There. Right, and this was pretty much all I needed, wasn't it? This I can put here. That's never gonna happen. You get this with your rock thrower. Broken frostbite necklace. Old and worn, missing many links, still magical abilities. Here, just don't hold that for a moment. Or, I don't know, I'm just gonna... never mind. It bothers me that you're overloaded. You're carrying just too many guns. I want to keep the napalm... this one, you know, I'm just not going to use that for now. I hope it could be upgraded at some point. You're still carrying too much. That's really, really, really heavy. I'm just going to put it away. I'll get it out again later. Okay. Right, you have that... Anything else I needed? I was going to get... I got the Valtharian Mace. There was another... Oh, the Rock Thrower was the only other thing I needed to remember. Okay. Let's just discard those for now. In here, I guess. Okay. This box is for overflow gear and stuff. Alright, so if I go to the stables again... wait, this... Yeah, I'll keep that with me, I guess. If I go to the stables again, can I just be transported back there real quickly? I hope. Wait, where were the stables? Horse Travel Company traveling to Vale Village, offer services, yes. So as soon as I move, I travel, or it just takes a moment. Okay. So let me go ahead and craft this new paladin mace. See how much of an upgrade it is. I probably should have just put this away. Whatever. I don't know my way around this place yet. This is what I want, maybe? And did I bring enough mithril? It takes two, doesn't it? I think I brought one. I'm gonna need to buy one. Mace blueprints. Two mithril, one Valtharian mace, one improved mace blueprints. I hope this is what a Valtharian mace is, even though that's not actually its name. Sell me a mithril. Three silver. I can pay three silver. This is silver. Yep, that's what it is. Mithril star has been created. 1836. Okay, that's a big improvement. Very cool. Ignores more points of armor. Great. Okay. Yeah, this one can just go away now. Alright, great. So, that's improved, that's improved. Got some really amazing gloves for you, and some pretty cool gloves for you, too. Alright, and that's what the Pale Village looks like. So yeah, next time, I guess I'll probably go... There's a lot of river to explore, so I might do that. But also I'd like to go up north and see if I can find the Mage Tower and catch up with Sashen there. After that, I might just sort of branch out and go do some of these side quests, like the pirate ship would be fun, the sleeper's lair would be fun, maybe look for the last scroll in the marsh. It feels like this is a big empty section that might have something in it somehow, somewhere. Because I need at least one more scroll. Although it has to be more than one more, maybe, because, like, I tried all the four-button sequences that involved three twos, unless I'm misinterpreting this. Yeah, so this is bothering me slightly. Anyway, cool. Yeah, see you next time for Mage Tower and some other stuff, probably.